sea, Seagate. Firstly, I'd like to say how very proud we are to be trade partners for AOPP and supporting this this great event, the APAS. So if, for those of you who don't know, LaCie is data storage. We have a booth that's just right outside there. And this year we're really concentrating on USB-C data storage solutions, Thunderbolt 3 data storage solutions, and really about simplifying your workflow and ingestion, archiving, backup, working drive. We have solutions for all those steps of the workflow. So yeah, please, if you have time, come and visit our booth, and I'm happy to answer any questions at that booth if you for your data storage needs. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much to Andy and to LaCie. Lots of awesome products for photographers there. Okay, our judges to kick off this morning, we have Hilary Hahn, Andrew Campbell, Josh Holko, Ollie Dale, and Adam Finch. Morning, everyone. And as this is the Science, Wildlife and Wild Places Photographer of the Year category, I'm just going to read that the entries into this category may be accompanied by a caption, which I will read. Science images may include, but are not limited to, photomicroscopy, biomedical photography, images of specimens of plants or animals, images of artifacts, astrophotography, photographs of captive or controlled animals, and botanical subjects. Wildlife and wild places entries must be of nature, which includes wildlife and wilderness, both on land and in water. This is not a category for domestic animals, zoo animals, farm animals, captive wild animals, or cultivated plants. Adam, does your is your name on yours?
No, I'm Hilary Hahn.
Oh, so it's opposite.
Yeah, I'm Finchie.
And I'm Ollie.
I think we managed to say that we were all completely.
It's probably easier if we just swap chairs.
It's okay, I'm halfway through.
You'd think out of five, one would be
yeah.
Right.
That's it.
I am.
Excellent. Thank you.
I am.
Everyone is who they are in their panels. Excellent. Okay, print handlers, can we please begin with the first print? Lion heading towards shade during the intense heat of the day. Masai Mara, Kenya, 2017. This print scores 80, silver award. Hilary, let's kick off with a quick comment from you about this print, please.
Can you hear? Oh. I scored this in the silver range. It's got. I love the movement that they've put into it, and considering it's the heat of the day, with the light will be contrasty. I think they've done a very good job.
Thank you very much for that. Next print, please. The dominant male grizzly bear feeding on sedge grass in the Katsimatin Grizzly Bear Sanctuary, northern British Columbia. Sedge grass is up to 25% protein, and the spring grizzly bear's diet is made up to 70% sedge grass to replenish the lack of protein during hibernation. this print scores 77. Josh, you're right on the average. Could we get a comment from you, please?
I was immediately attracted to this print when it turned around because I love the fact that the photographer got down nice and low. And there is some really wonderful eye contact there, which is fantastic. I felt that the print quality let it down a little bit.
Great. Thank you very much. Next print, please. A newly emerged turtle hatchling heads off into the ocean for the first time. This print scores 77. Adam, could we get a comment from you, please? You're on the average.
I just think it probably needs a little bit of a slightly different crop or kind of perspective to the image, and I'd like to see a little bit brighter as well.
Thank you, Adam. Next print, please. While heavy rains soak a parched land, cloud to ground lightning reaches out like fingers across the sky to locate the point where the electricity will discharge from the ominous skies. Multiple flashes with strong winds during the exposure has the windmill being captured in different positions. This print scores 84, silver award. And Hilary, you were right next to the average, 83.
Yes, I like I think the way the photographer's caught the movement in the windmill and the clouds, that heavy oppressive feeling, I think it's been captured beautifully.
Thank you. Next print, please. Flamingos. Marismas, Guadalhavia, Spain. This print scores 84, silver award. Andrew Campbell, bang smack on the average there at 84.
I'm enjoying the drama of the print and the composition. I think the fact that the birds are all flying in formation is an absolute bonus, well captured.
Great, thank you very much. Next print, please. Near Svalbard's White Island, a young walrus stirs before returning to dozing. The walrus, Obedinus rosmarus, is listed as vulnerable. By majority, this print scores 79. Is it okay, is that two challenges there? But that was both of you putting your hands up? Okay, that's fine. I'm going to take Ollie's challenge Andrew's in actually a bit above you, but I'm going to take yours, Ollie, at 84. Andrew was at 87. Then we had 79, 77 and a 75. So go ahead, Ollie.
Yeah, I think this this image deserves an award in the silver range. It's not something, it's not like it's totally unique. However, the way it's been presented to us, and especially that last comment about this creature being quite vulnerable, the printing that has been given to us leaves that vulnerability to it. I think if we wanted more harshness to the scene or we wanted more contrast or something like that, it takes it out of that sense of vulnerability. He's all alone in this place. He's been presented that way to us. He's, you know, looking at us, but he's cute, but he's vulnerable. And that softness, I was challenged by that at first, but then when I heard that comment about vulnerability, I loved it, and I felt that it was very strongly in a silver range. I gave it 84.
Thanks, Ollie. Josh, you were on 75.
Yeah. Look, I get what you're saying, Ollie, and with a great deal of respect, I don't get that vulnerability in this image. I find the print to be quite cloudy, and I find that the top section of the print to be not really adding anything to the image at all. I don't get a sense of the environment, really, and I find the crop doesn't really help the pose of the walrus. For me, it doesn't quite make it into the award standard. I think it's a nice capture. And it's the sort of photograph that, you know, if you're travelling to an area like this, you might hope to come home with. And anyone who did would be very, very happy with it. Is it an award standard? I'm not sure. For me, it is.
Thanks, Josh. Andrew, you were in silver distinction range on 87.
Yeah, sorry, Josh. Respectfully disagree with some of those comments. I really am enjoying the balance. I'm really enjoying the gentle, soft, ethereal nature of the light that's hit the subject. I kind of just want to get up and tickle his tummy. He's kind of cute, you know, and I kind of think that out there in the wild, to take that stillness and moment and make it almost a caricature is something that I think the author's done very, very well. So I'm very comfortable with it being a silver.
Thanks, Andrew. Ollie, you get a right of reply.
Yeah, I agree with the balance side of it. I think that cloudiness in the image is mirrored in the cloudiness of the sky. I think if it was cropped in just on him or closer to the horizon, it would be really heavy and obnoxiously pointed at him. I think this is him in his environment. It is a cloudy day. You get a cloudy print. There's no sunlight, so it's really lacking in contrast. And I just felt that that took that up into a lower award category at silver.
Okay, judges. So our average, our majority score is 79, even though we had an average of 80. Ollie's locked in at 84, but everyone else can rescore. And for the benefit of the audience, we had three judges in the high 70s, which is why we say we have a majority score. That overrides the average. Our judges work as a team. Don't have yours yet, Andrew. It's come through here now. Yep. I've got the known button. I don't have your score, though. Perfect. I think so. This print scores 82, silver award. And we are going to keep our judges rotating pretty quickly through this category. Thank you, Hilary. No comment necessary because we've got to talk about it. And I'm going to bring on Mandarin. Mandarin Montgomery. As Mandarin comes up, we'll have the next print, please.
Yes, sorry. We only need to... we need to speak about every print.
A social pod of nine humpback whales hangs together in the tropical breeding waters of the Kingdom of Tonga. This print scores 83, silver award. May I have a comment, please? Josh Holko.
There's a lot to love about this print, and I think for me the thing that stands out the most is I actually really adore the way the light rays are coming down through and focusing on one of the whales. I think it brings the eye to a nice focal point, and I think the surrounding whales really help to balance the photograph. It's very well taken.
Thank you very much. Next print, please. Elephants grazing, Lake Kariba, Zimbabwe. This print scores 76. Ollie, you were right next to the average. Can I have a word from you, please?
Yeah, graphically really interesting, especially with those really dark elephants at the bottom, and sits comfortably in the professional standard. A well-taken, well-executed shot.
Thanks, Ollie. Next print, please. A polar bear near Svalbard shares its kill with a latecomer. The bear is listed as vulnerable. The ivory gull standing nearby has near threatened status, while the passing glaucus gull is not threatened. The seal is unidentified. This print scores 81, silver award. But we're going to have a challenge because Mandarin has it on 88. There is an 83, 80, two 80s actually, and a 76 for you, Mandarin. Take it away.
This print is extraordinary. I really enjoy the way it's been printed, but I love the compositional elements, the storytelling elements. The gull that is in flight actually ties the image together. The wings actually draw the viewer into that amazing expression of the grizzly that's looking towards the camera. I genuinely believe this is a silver distinction, and I'd love to hear some more from the other judges.
Ollie, you're on 76.
I've probably underscored this one a little. When I first saw the image, I was confronted by a degree of difficulty, and I thought that was massive, like the chances of getting the shot so slim. But that I can't judge on degree of difficulty. I guess I didn't get the metaphor or the connection that the gull in flight brought, and I appreciate that comment. So I'm willing to listen, and I'm probably going to come up to silver.
Okay, Josh, you were the next highest on 83.
I agree with everything Ollie just said. I think the degree of difficulty is very high, and I think it's really fantastic to see the ivory gull with the polar bears, with the kill, with the glaucus gull, and from that perspective, it's wonderful. The print quality, I think, sits nicely in the silver range. I'm not sure there's enough there for me to go into silver distinction with this, but I think the crop is also very effective. It's a very well executed print, and I'm very comfortable with it in the silver range.
Mandarin, your right of reply.
Thanks for all those comments. I just think this is still an extraordinary image. The texture of the fur on the bears is just so beautifully technically produced, and also that little gull that's standing there has got one foot up as if he's sort of unsure about whether he's going to be the next meal. The storytelling elements of this are really beautiful, and I encourage everyone to come up to a Silver Distinction.
So our average score is 81, Mandarin's locked in at 88, but everyone else can rescore. Print scores 84. Good solid silver. And because we're at nationals, it will also go for review at the end of this category. Has another opportunity. Next print, please. The shy cassowary was peeping out from the dense dane tree rainforest. He was waiting for the cars to clear so he could forage on the fallen fruit in the car park of the Discovery Centre. A chance illumination by a car headlight cast enough light on him. This print scores 76. May we have a comment, Adam Finch?
I certainly enjoy the image and where the description of the car headlight really kind of gave me a little bit of an extra element. I think it could improve is just some of those distracting elements between the camera position and the bird sort of maybe just looking at, you know, being very careful photographing to sort of minimise those extra distracting elements.
Great, thank you. Going to do another judge change. Thank you, Andrew. Bring on Cameron Attree. And as Cam comes up, we will have the next print, please. Three-month-long single exposure documenting the transition of the sun and corresponding local cloud cover during exposure. Shot using a homemade camera using a modified alternative process. All right. By majority, this print scores 79. However, we have an automatic challenge with Ollie on 96, 17 points away from the average. It's actually from the majority score. The average was 83. So we're going to have a chat about this one. Adam Finch was in Silver Distinction on 88. So Ollie, we'll come to you first to kick us off. You won't get a right of reply. And we'll have a word with Cameron after you. Take us away, Ollie.
This, to me, is what photography is all about. This is, to me, so innovative in its storytelling. I could sit down with my kids and talk for hours about the universe from this one image. The length of time it's taken to capture this, the storytelling, the science that's involved, this is outstanding. Yeah, it's not crisp. Who cares? This is photography. This is experimentation. This is creating an image that tells a story, that has a message that is really powerful. And I really want to see you guys bring that up because this is an outstanding image for me.
Cameron from 76. Not alone. There were two 77s in this as well.
Yeah, I get what Ollie's trying to get across there. But for me, without that description, the image was completely lost. I couldn't get any interpretation of what the subject matter exactly was just by looking at the image. I know, you know, in this category we do sometimes rely on the description, but I guess I'm certainly happy to listen a little bit further and reconsider my score, but not certainly not. Would have to have a lot more discussion to get up to a gold for me.
Well, Adams and Silver distinction. Have a word with us, Adam, from 88.
Yeah, look, I actually found this sort of a very intriguing image and kind of, I guess, sort of taking kind of the frontier of photography quite new. If we look back at sort of the 1800s and those initial sort of photographs and the long exposures and the shoe shine and being the first person featured in an image and so forth. Sorry, the person getting his shoe shine, rather. This is a similar kind of thing. We're taking a really incredibly long exposure, but what the photographer has actually done is given us design, has given us a lot of pre-thought in constructing this image outside of the science that's involved in making sure that we actually, after such a long period of time, render something that is recognisable. Yes, we do need a description to fully appreciate it, but I find it quite a pleasing, interesting, absorbing image just on its own without that benefit of exactly what I'm looking at. I think we all come preloaded with a certain amount of knowledge, and to an astrophysicist, they'd probably immediately recognise it as being the movement of the sun without needing some guidance. So, as you would recognise a dog without needing guidance. So I think I want to give the author, the photographer, the benefit of the sun knowledge and their knowledge and reward it as such. I was at Silver Distinction, and I'm certainly listening to Ollie's comments and looking at moving it further up.
Okay, so because this is an automatic challenge, you all have the opportunity to change your scores if you wish. We had an average score of 83, but with three of you in the 70 range, the majority score was 79. So you can all rescore now. Print scores 87, Silver with distinction. Nice work, judges. Next print, please. Slim pickings. Australasian gannets normally present some fresh greenery to potential mates as a courtship gift. Needless to say, this guy was alone on the edge of the colony. This print scores 78. Cameron, you're right on the average. Can you give us a comment, please?
Yeah, print quality really, really, really nice. I think it sits quite nicely in the professional practice. There was a really nice story to that in the image as well, so I think the author's done a good piece of communication there.
Thank you. Next print, please. A 16-image layered panorama of a supercell thunderstorm surging over the Midwest region of Western Australia. A warm, humid environment promotes rapid lifting of the air, and changing wind direction as the air rises allows the clouds to appear like a mothership. This print scores 83, silver award. Mandarin, can we get a comment from you, please?
Incredible tonality, really ominous exposure of those clouds, really dark and foreboding. Beautiful image.
Thank you very much. Next print, please. A huntsman spider, family Sporacidae, according to the Australian Museum arachnologist, who could not identify it further. It was found along a track off the State Mine Road near Lithgow in January 2017, captured using a flash and a reflector that also served as a windbreak. By majority, this print scores 84, silver award. And judges, because you can't see each other's scores, we had 384s and 286s. So pretty close call there. And it will go for review at the end of the category. Another judge change. Oh, sorry, yes, thank you, a comment. Ollie, can we hear from you, please?
A real beautiful graphic to this nature shot, and from afar back it's really interesting, and then up close it's really interesting too. So well done to the author.
Thank you very much. We are going to do another judge change. Thank you to Josh, and we'll bring on David Evans. We will have the next print, please. Light-years distant, the Great Carina Nebula is a star-forming region 300 light-years across. The centre contains Eta Carina, a massive star 100 times the size of our Sun and on the verge of a supernova explosion. 7-panel mosaic, 62 hours exposure, 3 narrowband filters. Print scores 85, silver with distinction. Ollie, you were bang on that average.
I was. I must admit, I find judging these images hard because they're just so hard to get. But this is such a beautiful example of astrophotography that is captivating and has rewarding aspects from corner to corner. So I wanted to give it a silver distinction.
Thank you. Next print, please. A pair of Antarctic shags fly down the Lemaire Channel, Antarctica. This print scores 80, silver award. Adam, you were next to the average from 81.
Yeah, great sort of restrained colour palette, really nice design, placement of the birds. It's a really quite a beautiful image.
Awesome, thank you. Next print, please. Serengeti, Tanzania, during the short wet season, is a time of abundance for the predators and briefly, due to the great wildebeest migration, territories shrink and lion prides coexist. This male, just on sunset, arose to give his full attention on what may shortly unfold as a hunting opportunity. This print scores 78. Going to come to Ollie again on 78.
Beautiful portrait of a very powerful creature with an annoying piece of grass right in front of his face that kind of took me back out of the awards. But well done, just in the professional standard.
Thank you very much. Next print, please. Like a pencil sketch in the winter landscape, a wild reindeer displays its claim for a small patch of frozen tundra ground in the tough search for food during the frozen winter months in Svalbard. By majority, this print scores 84, and we'll go for review. Yes, silver award, thank you. Cameron, you scored 84.
I did. I thought it was very solid silver, a really nice design. The colour palette is beautiful. The print handling is really nice, so I'm quite happy where it's at.
A lot of positive comments, thank you. Next print, please. This 8 centimetre in size female spotted pardalote watches from a thorn-covered twig for a safe moment before entering her tunnelled nest chamber. This print scores 80, silver award. But David's going to challenge it. David's on 86. There's an 84, 83, 75 and a 74 for you, David.
Okay, so I've got a bit of support here, I think, with a couple of other judges. What I really like about this is it's very simple, but just the contrast between the sharpness of the bird in the print, which is really, really beautiful, compared to the really nice patterns in the background, which is obviously out of focus. And the stance of the bird looking to the right sort of personifies the bird a little bit, sort of makes it a bit cartoonish. And, you know, there's a lot of bird pictures which don't really quite have the same quality as this. It's a very simple image, but I think it's been printed so well, and just that contrast, not only in the tones, but also in the focus, really makes this worthy of a silver distinction.
Thank you. Adam Finch, you are on 74. I'm sure the name has nothing to do with it.
I don't disagree with anything that you said. I probably find the pattern in the background and that brightness to be a little bit distracting. And I sort of find the bottom half of the bird kind of blends a little bit too much into the twig. Sort of, there's not as much separation as I'd maybe like to see. I'm listening though. Maybe I've been a little harsh on the 74 end, but silver distinction is a different ball game.
Let's hear from Ollie. You were on 84.
Yeah, I was guilty of sitting on the fence. I'll be coming up. The impression I got when I first saw it was, oh, it's just another bird photo. But the more you sit with this, the more it grows on you. And yes, there is a little bit of lack of definition, but there is detail in there, and so the author has controlled this really well, and the brightness around it gives this darkness and this detail a place to sit. And the more I look at it, the more I love it, so I'll be coming up to the distinction.
David, you're about to reply.
Yeah, look, I think ultimately I mentioned that the bird is sort of almost personified, and I think it's because the profile that we've got of the bird looking to the right brings us straight to the point of highest contrast around its beak and eye, and I think that's just really, really important with this. This is a really nice bird portrait, not just a bird picture.
Thank you. Our average is 80. David's locked in at 86. Everyone else can rescore. by majority. Print scores 85, silver distinction. Next print, please. Male weedy seed dragon, Philip Terex tania latus, gracefully making its way through the seaweed beds in the cold winter waters of Warbs Bay, Bisheno, Tasmania. This print scores 82, silver award. Ah. But we have an automatic challenge to the negative. Although Mandarin wanted to do an elective challenge, because Mandarin was on 90, but because we had Adam 10 points away on 72, we're going to take the automatic challenge. And we're going to start with Adam. You're going to kick us off. But Mandarin, being in the 90 range, will definitely come to you as well. There will be no right of reply, Adam, but talk to us about your 72.
I enjoy the graphic nature of the image. I found the cropping to be a little too tight, in particular on the top of the creature. The banding, the print banding on the left-hand side of the image in the blue in the print is distracting, and then I find the kind of transitional banding on the right hand side through those blue to green to be distracting as well. And as for a professional quality in a professional print awards, this is sort of a little bit inexcusable, and I've reflected that in my score. But I'm listening.
Thank you, Adam. David, you were right on the average at 82.
I really like the image overall, but I did notice the banding, the vertical lines and the transitional banding as well, and I probably would have been higher, but I really love it so much that I'm comfortable on silver.
And Mandarin from 90.
If ever, in my opinion, there's a decisive moment of images of sea dragons, this is it. That is captured absolutely perfectly. The little fin just melds beautifully into the seaweed. It all follows through. There's a beautiful flow. The cropping, I don't feel, is too tight. It keeps drawing our eye back into comparing the sea dragon with the seaweed. There's a little bit of banding, which is unfortunate, but, I definitely believe, I put it in gold, and I definitely believe it's at least worthy of a silver distinction. So I'd love people to come up.
So our average score was 82. Because that was an automatic challenge, everyone may change their scores if they wish. Please enter your scores now. Print has gained a point and gone to 83. Nice solid silver. Next print, please. Perito Moreno Glacier, Patagonia, Argentina. This print scores 82, silver award. Ollie, can we get a comment from you? You were right on the average.
Yeah, I think this is a rewarding image that I think probably needs to be bigger. There's so much detail and so much beauty in those colours that we've been left with, and that scale given to us by the people. I think it's undersized potentially, but well done on a silver, well done.
All right, thank you. And thank you for that comment. We're going to give you a break and bring back Hilary Hahn. We'll have the next print, please. Humpback whales are protective of their newborn calves and will stay within proximity, using grunts and whistles to communicate to a curious youngster. By majority, this print is a silver distinction, 85. Let's go to Adam Finch for a comment, please.
I really enjoy how the photographer has chosen to keep the calf quite dark and have the mother really forward and really sort of almost menacing in its both sort of pose and brightness, and yeah, like really lovely image from the author.
Thanks, Adam. Next print, please. Skua and chin strap penguins, Robert Island, South Shetland Islands. This print scores 80, silver award. David, tell us about this print.
Yeah, really, really nice capture with the position of the bird and the penguin on the rock. Really nice backlighting to accentuate the penguin. Perhaps if I was to improve this even more, it might be just to crop a little from the bottom.
Perfect, thank you very much. Next print, please. Mother cheetah with her two juveniles survey the Masai Mara, Kenya, 2017. By majority, this print scores 80, silver award. Hilary, can we have a word from you about this one, please?
Yes, it's a nice moment captured. And I think there's just a few processing things that I would have maybe corrected just to bring it up a bit more, but lovely image.
Thank you, Hilary. Next print, please. Pseudecus porphyriacus, red-bellied black snake. This print scores 72. Mandarin, could you give us a quick comment about this one, please?
I was on that score. It's a great image, but the reason why I didn't go higher was I found that the image would work better if it was cropped in tighter. I found that the lack of detail, the out of focus, rest of the body and the tail was very distracting. The texture in the top half of the snake is where it's at, and also that the grass I found a little distracting, so maybe deepen it down so your focus is more on that snake.
Thank you very much. A couple of good tips there. Next print, please. A tiny wave crashes on shore. With no wind, the surface of the water has no ripples, making for a blown glass look. This print scores 76. And David's going to challenge from 82. There's two 76s and two 73s for you, David. Go right ahead.
Okay, so I'm talking about a silver here. I think this is really quite mesmerising. So when it first turned around, the initial impact for me was really that it made me feel that I was really immediately there. And so I think the print's been handled really nicely. As far as wave pictures go, it's reasonably unique in the way that it's been presented as a square crop, I think. And I gave it a low silver. I think it's definitely worthy of another look from everyone.
Cameron, you're on 73.
73, and I'm pretty happy with it in a professional practice sort of area. I take on board all those comments, and I do actually agree with those comments from David that I like the presentation of the square, but I just feel the composition's a little bit off. I think if the photographer was a touch lower, it would have, you know, really brought you into that the curve and yeah, would have just drew you into the image a lot more.
And Hilary from the average at 76.
Yes, I agree with many of David's comments. I just don't think it's enough to bring it into that silver award. I think it's fairly comfortable in good professional practice. Mm-hmm.
David, you're right to reply. The final score was 76.
Okay, I think we can bring it into slightly better professional practice to just encourage the author. And I'd like to also suggest to the photographer that they might like to try this in black and white as well, because I think the textures and the tones would be really, really nice.
Okay, so average score is 76. David's locked in at 82, but everyone else can rescore. And print has gained 2 points, 78. Next print, please. Peregrine falcons have adapted to thrive in both the natural and man-made environment. This wild bird shows its fierceness and agility near its home on Sydney's northern beaches. Our sponsor for this category is Lessie. They have some wonderful products that would be very useful for photographers, so make sure to check them out if you're here at the trade show, or if you're here on live stream, give them a quick Google. We've got some beautiful things. And this print scores 81, silver award. David, you're on the average.
It's a remarkable capture in terms of the position of the bird. It reminds me of a fighter jet circling around for another bombing run, and it in its environment on the northern beaches, the image just shows everything that it needs to. So.
Thank you. Next print, please. Gentoo penguins rest on an ice floe beside an iceberg, Antarctica. This print scores 82, Silver Award. Comment, please, from David again. You're right on the average.
This is a nice little story. There's a lot of things that you can imagine about what these penguins are doing or thinking or where they're going in their environment. In terms of improvement, I think a little bit of a crop from the right, that edge on the right, might work. But otherwise, it's a really, really nice image.
Thanks, David. We'll have the next print, please. The highly distinctive chrysalis of the Euploea core of the Australian common crow butterfly, as found in a neighbour's yard. Here it has been isolated using off-camera high-speed sync flash techniques. This print scores 82, Silver Award. Oh, but Hillary's going to challenge because she's on 88. Let's see, Hillary, you've got an 83, 82, 81 and a 78.
Thanks. Yes, I deliberated quite a bit, but I really think it deserves a silver distinction. It's the lovely graphic nature of it, the chrysalis that sort of almost could be a skull of something, the detail in it, and it's so simple. And in nature photography, it's quite hard sometimes to get that really simple graphic look. And I just thought it's shows quite a bit of innovation and creativity to get to that level. I think it deserves a few more points.
Let's hear from Mandarin. You're on 78.
Yeah, I am listening. It is a pretty extraordinary print that I put into professional practice. The reason why I didn't go a little higher was I would have loved to have seen it shot from slightly further over to the right, so that skull, as you put it, because I did see it too, was a little bit more front on. And also it could have been then cropped square, and therefore I feel graphically that would have been better. Also, I would love to have seen a little bit more detail in that object. It's just lacking a little bit in the highlights and the shadow areas.
Cameron, you were near the average. You were from 83.
Yeah, 83, and again, I think I'm pretty well happy with that score. To get it up to silver distinction, I probably would have liked to have seen a little bit more of the environment. And I know we've separated that with the off-camera flash, and it's done a really good job, but I think it's lacking a bit of story, and a bit more environment would have improved that.
Okay. Hillary, your right of reply.
I quite agree with points made by Mandarin and Cameron. It's I think if it had been square and round a little bit more, I would have gone higher. I quite agree with that. I don't think it needs more of an. I suppose it's subjective. I've gone to the point that it's a real graphic. I don't feel that there's any need for any environment in this particular, the way it's been presented to us. So, and that's just a difference, a personal difference of opinion. But I think that what we presented with is very creative, and I would love to see it go a bit higher.
Thank you, Hilary. So our average score is 82. Hilary's locked in at 88. Everyone else can rescore, please. And the print scores 85, a silver distinction. I'm going to do a judge change. Thank you, Adam. We'll bring back Ollie Dale. And have the next print, please. Six-month-long single exposure documenting the transition of the sun and corresponding local cloud cover during exposure. Shot using a homemade camera using a modified alternative process at Port Noralaga, SA. If I apologise if I butchered the name there. This print scores 87, silver with distinction. However, we've got a challenge from Mandarin. She's on 90. We've got two 88s, an 84 and an 83 for you, Mandarin. Take it away.
I'd love to congratulate the photographer on their courage in creating an image that took 6 months to produce. It is extraordinary. When it spun around, the compositional quality of this blew me away. The positioning of the jetty and the star trail, the sun, is extraordinary. It's almost like feathers or you know, butterfly wings. The tonality is beautiful. I love that old world quality. It's like, you know, the old masters from the 1800s. So I scored it gold, and I genuinely believe it deserves a gold.
Hilary, you were on 83. You were the lowest score, but you've also marked the known button. So that's okay. We just acknowledge that.
Am I? Yep. Okay, thanks. I agree with your points, Mandarin. I just don't know that that brings it up to gold level for me. I stuck it in a really good solid silver and feel quite comfortable with the image as it's presented to me, the composition. I love the tonal range. I think it's very beautiful, but I'm just not sure that it has enough visual communication beyond that to take me higher.
Ollie is in silver distinction on 88.
Yeah, I probably underscored it. I'll be coming up to gold. Visual communication, the story is in the lines. So as the sun passes every day, some days you have clear days, some days you don't. Some days it starts clear and then the clouds roll in. And that's written and etched into this image across a period of 6 months where we're getting the weather patterns for each day and each line. And the compositional element of this is what grabbed me the first time, but again, it's one of these amazing things. We could be standing on another planet looking out at the rings that float around us. It's that kind of, it takes us out of this planet and out into space. And so this is an amazing kind of concept, and it's presented in such a beautiful way that I definitely underscored it at 88. I'll be coming up.
Mandarin, your right of reply.
Thanks for all those comments. I definitely agree with them. I still believe it deserves a gold. The beautiful ethereal quality of that, when you know the details of the image, it takes it up to that next level. When you don't know the details, it's really mysterious. The mind boggles. What are those lines in the sky? But the tonal gradation of the water, the shadow under the jetty, the sky, everything about it, especially the composition, the beautiful vertical composition, That is a gold image there. 6 month exposure, it's extraordinary.
So our average score is 87. Mandarin has locked herself in at 90, but everyone else can rescore. Gold award at 90. And can we just have a blank screen, please? We've got a bit of an issue with the live stream, so we're just going to have a chat with our judges. Now, Ollie, you're here from New Zealand, and you are a fellow of NZIP, is that right?
That's correct, yes. I gained my fellowship in 2013, I think.
That's fabulous. And what does it take to become a fellow?
You need to have 30 points, at least one gold, and at least three silvers, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
So in New Zealand, where our point structure is slightly different, we get 3 points for a gold, 2 for a silver, and 1 for a bronze. There's no distinction changes. And you have to earn a certain number of points in a 4-year period to stay active. So I won 3 golds in the fusion category over 3 years, and then I got a gold print, and that gave me a bar to my fellow in 2014. So it takes a bit of work, but the Grandmaster is even harder. You've got to have 80 points and 50 million golds and all this other stuff, so it's really tough.
Hilary, welcome from South Australia, and you're a master photographer?
Yes, I can't remember. I achieved it a couple of years ago, yeah. So I'm just waiting for my first gold bar. Please, God.
This year, maybe?
I hope so. Fingers crossed. Fingers crossed.
And what do you normally photograph, Hilary?
Wildlife, mm-hmm. pretty well. In a more art sense. So I do straight wildlife, but I don't tend to market that particularly. I sell it for textbooks and those sort of things, but more the art side is what interests me.
Fabulous. Yeah. Cameron Attree is here from Queensland. Master
Hello.
Photographer with 3 gold bars.
Yes, got my 3rd gold bar last year. Mm. So I think I'm back to square one again until my 4th. So.
And you shoot a little bit of everything, don't you?
I do, yeah. And I actually started shooting wildlife and landscape, you know, after I graduated from Queensland College of Art. Did that for a number of years. And then gradually started shooting people. And my passion now is shooting the human form in the landscape. So combining those sort of passions. Yeah.
Mm, awesome. David, also from South Australia. Tell us about your qualifications. What have I got here? You're your master photographer. Lovely. Love that red ribbon. If anyone in the audience sees anyone walking around with a red ribbon, that's what that means. It's a master photographer.
Oh. Yeah, they don't want to hear from me. Yeah. yeah, South Australia. I shoot travel, landscape and commercial. A lot of commercial work I do is in the landscape. So a lot of work in the wine industry, for example. Mm. And I like collecting erasers and Dungeons and Dragons and Choose Your Own Adventures. No.
Oh, fabulous. And Mandarin, a local on the panel?
Yes, very excited to be here. This is my first year judging at APA.
Woohoo!
And I'm really enjoying it. I particularly love this category. While I am a conceptual portrait photographer, that's what I really love to do. Many of my elements come from the landscape, and I'm a bit of a science geek as well. So this is a really inspirational category with lots of very intriguing images. And yeah, I'm really excited. Hopefully this year I get my 3rd gold bar. Yeah.
Fingers crossed.
Thank you.
And we also have Joshua Holko sitting, waiting his turn patiently to come back on the judging panel. No, you're right. You're going to wrap up in a minute. Master photographer with 1 gold bar. Yeah, awesome. Andrew Campbell with his beautiful black ribbon. That's the Grandmasters. Woohoo, that's awesome. And Gary Cranich, another master photographer. So we've got some fabulous judges here on our panel today. And I think we're just about ready to kick off again.
We're going to take a break now, so what break if we can have the judges back at 11.
Mm-hmm. right, guys, we are going to take a quick break. We will be back at 11. So go and see our sponsors, particularly Lessee, who are sponsors of this category. Make sure you check out all their gadgets and goodies that they've got. Stretch your legs, get a coffee, have a relax, refresh your minds, and we will be back here at 11 sharp. Judges back at 11, and we recommence the judging shortly after that. Thanks very much, guys.